Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 20th video class of DIP, we'll study image sharpening, that is high pass filters, in frequency domain filtering and its implementation in MATLAB. So what is the meaning of image sharpening? Image sharpening means to make our image sharp or to highlight the boundaries or edges or sharp discontinuities in the image. Okay, so it is the reverse process of smoothing. In smoothing, we were making the image smooth. We were removing the edges and boundaries, right? Whereas here we'll be highlighting the edges and boundaries and removing the background. So this is known as high pass filtering. So this will perform in the frequency domain, and of course we will implement it in MATLAB. So in the previous two video classes, we have thoroughly understood fundamentals of frequency domain filtering for digital image processing, as well as image smoothing in the frequency domain filtering. And now the concepts of filtering in the frequency domain are quite clear to us. So it will be very easy to understand high pass filtering. Okay, let us start. We know that frequency domain filters can be broadly classified into two categories, low pass filters and high pass filters. The other variations we'll be learning later. Low pass filters we have already studied, which are of three types, ideal, Butterworth and Gaussian. And in this video class, we will study high pass filters or sharpening frequency filters, that is ideal high pass filter, Butterworth high pass filter and Gaussian high pass filter. So now the equations for high pass filters will be just the opposite of the low pass filters, right? For example, ideal high pass filter will give h of uv is equal to 0 if d of uv is less than or equal to d0 and 1 otherwise. Okay, for low pass filters it was 1 and 0, right? For Butterworth high pass filters, the equation is 1 upon 1 plus d0 by d of uv raised to 2n, whereas for the low pass filters it was d by d0, right? Here it is d0 by d. And for Gaussian high pass filters, the equation is again same, just it is 1 minus e raised to minus d square uv upon twice d0 square. There it was only e raised to minus d square uv upon twice d0 square. So let us see the equations once again for low pass filters. See, for low pass filters, it is 1 over here and 0 over here. It is d upon d0, whereas for high pass, it is d0 by d. And for Gaussian low pass, it is e raised to minus d square upon twice d0 square. Whereas for high pass, it is 1 minus e raised to minus d square upon twice d0 square. Okay. Again, the same important points. This has got a sharp discontinuity and hence ringing effect is present. What is the ringing effect? We have already learned in the previous video class. For Butterworth, it does not have a sharp discontinuities and hence ringing is only observed for filters of higher orders, right? And for Gaussian high pass filters, the profile of Gaussian high pass filter is not as tight, hence no ringing effect is present. The special representation of frequency domain high pass filter can be seen in this figure. This is for ideal filter. This one is for Butterworth filter. And this is for Gaussian high pass filter. And this shows the corresponding gray level profiles for the ideal, Butterworth and Gaussian high pass filter. And you can see here that the rings are present due to the concentric components that are present in the gray level profile. Similarly, for Butterworth high pass filter, little bit ringings are present due to these components, which you can see here. While if you see the gray level profile of Gaussian high pass filter, then there are no concentric components, due to which there is no ringing effect observed and the output is sharp and clear. So ideal high pass filter will pass all the high frequencies, as you can see in the surface plot, and will be rejecting only the low frequencies, as you can see. So it is passing high frequencies and rejecting low frequencies. Here in this image, for the low pass filter, it was white inside and black outside. Here it is black inside, that is to be rejected. So lower frequencies are rejected. Why? Because you know that the center is very low frequency, or DC frequency you can say, and it goes on increasing as we go ahead, right? So up to this circle is D0, as you know, cutoff frequency, right? So this is D0. Okay, and if you take any particular point from the center, okay, so this center is m/2 n/2, and the distance of this particular line from the center is d of uv, where this is our m and this is our n. So you can see here that the high frequencies are passed and only this low frequency up to cutoff frequency d0 are rejected. This figure shows the results of ideal high pass filtering the image with D0 is equal to 15, D0 is equal to 30 and D0 is equal to 80 respectively. And you can see the problem of ringing is quite evident in figure A and B. You can see here, these are the rings. Here also the rings are easily visible. So when we implement ideal high pass filters, we'll be obtaining such results that we'll be implementing in MATLAB. So this is the MATLAB program for ideal high pass filters. The program is similar to the previous video class that we have seen. Just the difference is the implementation of the equations, right? So if the steps or concepts are not clear to you, you please refer to the previous two video classes, that is video class number 18 and 19 of digital image processing. So we are reading an image, we are finding the size of the image and storing in MNN, and we are assigning a cutoff frequency of 30 for this ideal high pass filter, and finding the Fourier transform, the Fourier transform of the input image without shift. Then we are shifting the origin and again displaying after the shifting, and now most of the energies are concentrated towards the center of the image. And now we can perform the filtering. We are finding out d of uv for different coordinates of u and v, and applying the equation of Euclidean distance finding from the center of the image, that is under root of u minus m by 2 whole square plus v minus n by 2 whole square. And if d of uv is less than or equal to d0, the output is 0, that is black, else the output is same as the input. And of course the filter is black in the center and white outside, that is we are rejecting the low frequencies and passing the high frequencies, therefore it is known as a high pass filter. And then again we'll be displaying ideal high pass filter, the surface plot of ideal high pass filter, and we'll be reshifting the origin of the filtered image and taking the inverse Fourier transform and displaying the real part of the filtered image. So let us run and see the output. You can see here, this is our input image. Fourier transform has the energy located towards the corner. We need to shift it to the center, and after shifting, this is the Fourier transform of our this input image. We are applying high pass filter, that means we are passing all the high frequencies and rejecting the low frequencies or mid frequencies, the surface plot of which is like this. So we are rejecting this portion and we are passing this portion. That means we are only showing the edges or boundaries, and we are rejecting the background of the image and all other energies. And this is our ideal high pass filter image. When we zoom this particular portion, you can easily see the rings which are present. And this is the ringing effect due to ideal high pass filtering. So to solve the problem of this ringing effect, we use a Butterworth high pass filter. Now if you change the cutoff frequency from 30 to 10 and see the output, you can see even more ringing in the output. You can see the rings clearly visible. So to solve the problem of this ringing effect, we are using a Butterworth high pass filter profile can be given like this. So here there is no sharp discontinuity, as you can see in the spatial plot also. Okay, there is a gradual change in the intensity level, and hence the ringing effects are very less. But as the order of the filter increases, the ringing effect will creep in. So this shows results of high pass filtering the image using a Butterworth high pass filter of order 2 with D0 is equal to 15, 30 and 80. So when you increase the order from 2 to 4, 5 and 20, okay, this profile will become the profile of an ideal high pass filter like this. And hence the order chosen should be less than 5. So this program shows Butterworth high pass filter. The program is similar to the earlier program. Here also we are assigning a cutoff frequency of 30, and the order of filter that we are choosing is 4. Okay, it should be ideally less than 5 so that ringing effects are very less. And the same implementation of D and H in the for loop. Let us run the program and see the output for filter of order 4. So now you can see, even for order 4, there are ringing effects that are visible here, as well as outside here. That means as the order of filter increases, of course, if the order is 1, okay, very less filtering is obtained. So when we use order of 4 or 5, the ringing effects are visible. And if we increase the order to say 20, let us see the output. So we have changed the order of this Butterworth filter to 20 and run the program. And now when you zoom this portion, you can clearly see the ringing effect. The rings are clearly visible even over here, here, everywhere. Okay, why? Because You can see this profile. In fact, this Butterworth filter has become an ideal filter, as you can see here. Okay, so now the profile is same to ideal high pass filter. Okay, and that is the reason why the rings are clearly visible, right? If you go even higher, the rings will be more high. And for the Gaussian high pass filter, there are no ringing that are seen in the output. Okay, you can see here the result of high pass filtering image with Gaussian high pass filter of order 2 with D0 is equal to 15, 30 and 80. And if you compare these figures with the Butterworth figures and ideal high pass filters, okay, the output is quite sharp without any ringing effect for Gaussian high pass filters, even if we choose a higher value of D0. The advantage of using Gaussian high pass filter is that the ringing effects are not at all observed. So you can see here we have chosen a cutoff frequency of 30, or you can say standard deviation sigma for the Gaussian curve as 30, implemented the Gaussian filter. Let us run and see the output. So you can see here, this is the surface plot, a bell shaped curve and a gradual transition from black to white. And when you zoom this, you can see that there are no rings that are present and the image is quite smooth, very smooth in fact. Okay, so the results are cleaner and smoother as compared to the results for Butterworth high pass filter and ideal high pass filter. Let us increase the cutoff frequency from say 30 to 90 and see the output 3 times, right? So you can see here now how the profile has become. The transition has become still very, very gradual. And when we zoom, okay, still you can see that there are no rings that are visible, right? So no matter what cutoff frequency you choose, no rings are visible or present for the Gaussian filter. And that is the advantage of Gaussian filter. So hence we can conclude that the Gaussian filtering is advantageous for both high pass as well as low pass filtering. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video class. Thank you very much.